In this screencast, I will demonstrate how to find data beginning with a general web search and applying a few specific strategies. As you learned in the Finding Data tutorial, using data can be an effective way to support your argument and communicate your message. As we go through this example, keep these three ideas in mind. We'll want to become more familiar with the topic, we'll want to determine what kinds of data are likely to be available, and we'll want to identify the places to find these data sets. This process can work for finding data across different disciplines and topics. We are going to start with a general web search to become more familiar with our topic. From there, we can follow some data search tips to find data to meet our needs. Let's search the topic, facial recognition software bias. On the results list, we want to identify credible sources that offer background information on our topic and that contain relevant data, lead to data sets, provide useful visuals, and topic terminology. News sources can be great for this need. Let's take a look at the article, Study Takes Aim at Biased AI Facial Recognition Technology. When skimming a news article, look at captions of visuals for an attribution that may link to the original researchers, academic institutions, government agencies, or other clues that may lead to a data set. Although this is not a data visualization, the image's caption does provide useful information, including the name of a researcher studying AI gender and racial bias, Debra G, and an affiliated institute, the Massachusetts Institute of Technology Media Lab. Skimming through the first paragraph, we learn that Debra G is in fact studying facial recognition bias in technology services with other researchers at MIT, which is spot on to our topic. As we continue to skim the article, we'll look for key facts, statistics, and terminology. Here are some key findings and statistics from the research. Additionally, we are introduced to the terms artificial intelligence and algorithms that can be used for future searches. A benefit of a broad search is finding news that provide context on a topic that may otherwise be missing from peer-reviewed articles. This article provides a compelling example of how facial recognition software bias can produce real negative outcomes. The article first mentions a key finding from the research. Amazon's facial recognition software had the highest level of bias compared to other reviewed software. Following that, the article points out that this same software was used by police in Florida to scan and match faces on cameras against those in criminal databases. With this context, it becomes clearer why researching facial recognition software bias is important. It's a great idea to check the end of an article to see if there are links to more resources. In this case, there are. Let's investigate the more information link. This is great. The link sent us to the MIT Media Lab webpage. Here's a link to download the research paper referenced in the article. Be aware that research articles may be located behind paywalls, in which case you would want to jot down the information about the article, such as the title, author's names, and publication date. With that information, you could use the library's search engine to try and locate the article. Let's skim the research paper for useful visualizations or summary data sets. Here are two data summary tables detailing the results of the study. A few of the key findings in this data set were mentioned in the news article. The next step in this process would be to create a visualization using this data. A visualization could make it easier to understand the information or to quickly identify trends, patterns, or outliers. Let's recap. This screencast demonstrated how a general web search can help you to become more familiar with a topic by finding background information and context, determine what kinds of data are available on a topic, and identify a place to find these data sets. If you have questions, please visit the Introduction to Data Visualization LibGuide or the Data, GIS, and Digital Projects Lab at the Kennedy Library. Happy searching!